Now, NBC5 First Warning Weather with meteorologist Tyler Jankoski.
Well, Tyler, speaking of Mother's Day, what can we expect for tomorrow?
Pretty good. I think it's a little bit better than today because we'll see a little more sunshine and probably less shower activity. So about as good as you can get if you're not talking about full sunshine. How about this picture in from the Champlain Valley? Jeffrey Trubish says these are likely plum trees with all the white blooms there. And I had to show one more skiing picture. No promises about next week, but this is Superstar at Killington. A little bit of groomed trail on the side, then the huge moguls. The Superstar quad still going strong there as we get into mid-May, and I think it will for a little while longer. Burlington right now, beautiful at 51. Some breaks in the clouds, northwest wind at 7 miles per hour. And we're looking at the mostly dry Mother's Day, as I mentioned, but then some showers back in here Tuesday and Wednesday. But by Wednesday, things change enough that we'll start a string of days that are dry with sun. So just got to wait a little while longer for that. We've still got this band of rain paralleling the Northway, basically up into the Malone area. Very light, most of us dry at this hour. And there's that nice dry wedge all the way back through Detroit. So tomorrow, I think there's some sun in the morning. If there's a pop-up shower, it would be in the afternoon later on, but not a big deal, generally speaking. 50 in Plattsburgh right now, 49 for Montpelier, 41 though in Saranac Lake. So futurecast shows the little bit of sun breaking through tomorrow with some clouds, but dry in the morning. And then as we go through the afternoon, just a handful of pop-up showers. So that's why I think it's a mostly dry day, not much more than that. But by Monday morning, there is a band of steady rain that gets up close to the Champlain Valley. It's out of here really fast, though, by about 9, 10 Monday morning. And for the rest of Monday, it's just whatever pops up during the day with the heating of the day. It's not very warm on Monday, but there will be some pop-up showers then, and we'll do it again on Tuesday. It's kind of like what we see in the summer, where it's dry in the morning, dry in the evening. But in those afternoon hours, when we get the afternoon high, there's just some puffy clouds and some of them have showers. But other than that, not a big deal. I mean, if you look at the rainfall map, we're barely getting anything. We still have the drought condition, moderate drought for many of us. So even though there's showers here Monday, Tuesday, it's just really not going to do much for the drought situation. And then we're back up near average high temperatures by Thursday. The average high is 67. Hard to believe it's already 67, but we won't be close to average until Thursday. We have a ways to go. So tomorrow morning, 40s for most of us, 40 in St. Jay, 44 for Burlington, and then low 60s. 60 in Stowe, 60 for Northfield, 62 in Burlington. The Tri-Lakes warmer than it was today, certainly about 54 for the high in Lake Placid tomorrow, 64 in Brattleboro. So here's the five-day forecast with a couple of showers on Monday and Tuesday, but not amounting to much. I really like the looks of Wednesday, especially Thursday, and possibly Friday and Saturday. If we're lucky, we'll get a four-day stretch there with 60s, close to 70, and plenty of sun. Liz?
Sounds good.